Trevor's bus and Tom's Jeep arrived at Pandy Lane Forest. The sun was blooming, and so was the flowers.
Whoa, what a fresh but somewhat unusually dry day. Those trees are certainly coming alive.
Well, make sure to stay clear from the heavily pollinated areas.
Right then. Before we set off, let's make some tents. We shall collect food later.
The mumbling mob went straight away at making camps. Trevor looked at Tom building a camp at ease and tried his best to get Dillis's attention while making a perfect tent.
Now then, here's the greatest tent anyone shall see. Not even him has anything on me.
Trevor pulled out the gear, but it was more of a sophisticated tent, so the poles were hard to tighten. In the end, Trevor managed to make a cross instead.
Well, this is good for sleeping with. Yeah, sleeping with intimidation at your every move. Daryl, what a blooming bother.
Now then, it seems like we've got all tended up. Now it's time to hunt for berries and even some bush leaves.
Bush leaves? But they can have some sort of bugs on them.
Bella fainted while Dillis fanned her with her handkerchief.
Sure, right, Tom. She often does get like this.
Roy. Now then, off we go. I'll even sing some songs on my ukulele, Shirley, to lighten the spirits up.
Oh, Darrow.
The crew split up in various ways to look for food. The floods were currently sat near some bushes.
Blimey, this heat is nothing like what we had back home.
Indeed, Mike. How are you and Mandy getting along?
Oh, I'm doing all right, Mum. Just waiting for the others to find some food so we can get back to the tent.
Well, I wonder how the others are doing.
Dillis, Trevor, Bella and Norman were currently running away from Tom and his sour singing.
Bloomin' heck! If I have to listen to singing Simon's tunes once more, I'll flip my head off! Indeed, Mrs. Price, I've heard the worst in my old singing classes.
Now then, everybody, don't tell anyone else, but I brought some sandwiches and some crisps. I don't think any of us could live off that flipping lifestyle.
Oh, Trevor, love, you're so thoughtful. I choose cheese and pickle.
Don't mind me, everyone, but I'm quickly gonna go off somewhere. I'll be back.
Be careful, Norman.
Norman ran off to find Mandy so she can share the chocolate she had with her. However, trouble was brewing. Two campers were having a bonfire, but ran off when they heard Tom singing nearby, but forgot to put out smoke of the cookout.